Bloodstock 2016. Let's blow the roof off this mother. Here with Brady from Conjurer, having just torn the new blood stage, a new anal pipe. Brady, vocals and guitar.
Hello.
Talking of anal pipes, that's not one of your tracks, is it?
No, it's not. I'm feeling that burn though, currently. It's been a rough few days.
So did you win a Metal to the Masses?
Yes, we did. We Leicester.
Oh.
Which was...
That's a pretty hard fought one. I think they're all hard fought, but the Midlands is a very tough,
one
to break through, isn't it?
It's a weird one because it was just far away enough for us not to be able to bring all our mates to every round. So it was one we were like, we'll do it because we want to play the gigs. And we know the promoter, Simon Yarwood, really well.
Okay.
We heard tales of Uprising, the final, which turned out to be incredible. Like, with Conan and Hell played, it was great.
Oh, you played at that?
Yeah, man.
Oh, that was awesome.
Yeah.
Was that intimidating, though, knowing that... Because do they have the Metal to the Masses stuff and then the Conan and Hell at the end?
It's one of those things, like, we've played with Conan a few times before and, like, we kind of just treat every gig as a gig. We just turn up, like, fucking do our thing and then hope for the best, really. But it's one of those, we've all been in loads of bands before, so that kind of intimidation thing, it's still there. Like, today we're all a little bit like, how's it going to go? But for the most part, we're just like... We know our shit, we're just going to get up there and do it. So it's quite a calm thing, really.
What is your shit? What do you play? Not what do you play instrument-wise, what does it sound like?
Get this a lot. It's a mixture of big, sludgy riffs.
Sounds good.
A lot of post-metal, some doom in there.
Sounds really good.
Death metal. Just, we try and take the best bits of everything we love and just smash it together and hope for the best. I'm not selling it, but...
Yeah, I think you've sold it to me. You've sold it to me well. Now, have you got anything... You've got something on Holy Raw Records?
Yes, we put out an EP mini-album called I or One or whatever you want to call it. People have been calling it Vertical Line because I made a joke on Facebook, which the rest of the band are really pissed off about. But, it came out 1st of July and the reception's been amazing. Like, first time any of us have had vinyl out as well. So we're like geeking out over that shit. It's really
so you can get it on vinyl. Can you get it on
vinyl, CD,
Bandcamp?
Digital download, Bandcamp, the
Fantastic.
Lot. We nearly sold out of CDs though. So get in on that shit quick.
Oh, brilliant. And then what's next?
Next, we've got Rifffest in Bolton next week. We're playing with Mutoid Man and Bosk in London. And then we've got a couple of tours around Damnation Festival,
which
we're playing, which is just for us, like Bloodstock and Damnation. It was like, if we could play them one day, that'd be incredible. And both of them this year, we did one of the Temples Fest replacement shows as well.
Yeah.
Which was utterly mental. We were on at like 3 in the afternoon and it was rammed. I mean,
they had to pull that together really quick, didn't they?
Our management company, Tone, like put on a couple of the shows and we got added last minute and it was just crazy from start to finish. So yeah, we've had a mental year.
Excellent.
So next year, there's some stuff that I'm not allowed to talk about, but it's getting bigger and it's getting better. And we're just like, if this can keep on happening, we're a happy bunch.
Awesome. Well, I look forward to seeing you in a different field somewhere.
Hopefully.
Next time I'll be able to come and see you play.
Oh, that'd be good.
Lovely to meet you.
Yes,
cheers,
you
buddy.
Too. Thank you very
Let's
much.
Let's have some horns to the camera.